Good morning everyone. How are you all? I hope you all are good and safe at home. And today we will start from chapter 12. Today we will take only two chapters, chapter 12 and chapter 13. And in chapter 12 we have only one exercise, and in chapter 13 also we have only one exercise. That's why both chapters we will do together. Now come on your chapter 12. Chapter 12, the unitary method. What is the meaning of unitary method? Unitary. This is unit and this is arity. When we have to find any term, when we have to find the value of single digit, single term, as like I am saying, I have 5 oranges and cost of 5 oranges is rupees 10, and you have to tell cost of 1 orange. How you will tell? When you will do division, 10 divide 5, that means what will come? 2 will come. That means cost of 1 orange is rupees 2. Your full exercise based on that simple topic only. And now come, unit means 1. What is the meaning of unit? Unit means 1. When we have to find single item, when we have to find, because first we will find that single item, afterwards we are able to tell most of the items. Now come on your question number 1. Your question number 1 is, X cost rupees 36 per dozen. How much will 18X cost? Dozen. What is the meaning of dozen? In one dozen, 12 articles we have. In one dozen, we have 12 articles. That means they are saying cost of 12X, because they are saying the cost of one dozen X. They are not saying 12X. But we have to find out, because in one dozen, we have only 12 material, 12 articles. That means cost of 12X is rupees 36. And what you have to find, because you have to tell cost of 18X. You are not able to tell directly. First we have to find for unit. Unit means 1. Cost of 1 egg is 36 divided by 12. What will come? 3. Because 12, 3 is a 36. Now you are able to tell, because cost of 1 egg, you know, cost of 1 egg is rupees 3, and you have to tell cost of 18x. That means more eggs you have to purchase. That means what you will do? 3 multiplied by 18. Why 3 multiplied by 18? Because cost of 1 egg is rupees 3. 18 3 is a 54. Now come on your question number 5. Because 2nd, 3rd and 4th, these questions are in your assignment. Question number 5th is, Mrs. Khemka uses 600 milliliter of ice cream to make milkshake for 4 people. That means ice cream used for 4 people is 600 ml. That much ice cream she is using in which? In milkshake. And we have to tell for one people, if only one people is there, how much ice cream she will use? 600 divided by 4. Why we are doing division? Because this is biggest term and this is smallest. When we have to tell about the unit value only, then we are doing division. If we have to tell more digits, because what unit digit is here? And we have to tell more digit, then we are doing multiplication. Exactly only these two topics you have to mention in your notebook and mention in your mind, and you have to keep in your mind when you are doing that type of sums. That means ice cream used for 4 people is 600 ml, and ice cream used for 1 people is 600 divided by 4. Then what will come? 150 ml. And you have to tell ice cream used for 10 people. That means 150 into 10 is 1500 milliliter. Now your question number 7 is, question number 6 is an assignment. Question number 7, 6 bags of rice weigh 120 kg. And you have to tell how much will 9 such bags weigh. That means weigh of 6 rice bags. That means we have rice bags. How many bags we have? 6 bags we have. And which, whatever bags? Rice bag. Weight of. Weigh means weight of. We are taking 6 bags. Now quantity is higher. That's why we are using weigh here. Not weight. This is weigh. Weigh of 6 rice bags is 120 kg. And you have to tell weigh of 1 rice bag. How you will tell? You have to do division. 120 divided by 6 is 20 kg. And weigh of 9 bags are 20 into 9, 180. And in last question, 8 number is in your assignment. And in last question, 9th question, a factory made by bicycles in 7 days. How many bicycles that factory made? 3500. Bicycles made in 7 days is 3500. That means in one day how much they are producing? 3500 divided by 7. What will come? 500. That means in one day they are making, they are producing, they are making 500 bicycles. And you have to tell for 30 days. 30 days means 1 month. If they are saying only 1 month, that means you are able to tell. 1 month means 30 days. 500 multiplied 30, what will come? 15,000 bicycles. That means in full month, how much bicycles that factory made, that company made? 15,000 bicycles. Now your chapter 13. Chapter 13 is of patterns, and in this chapter also we have only one exercise, and in your question number 1 we have, in this we have to just follow the pattern. These are only my question. We don't have to solve any calculation, we don't have to check any method, we don't have to learn anything. Only little bit you have to use your mind, and little bit attention you have to pay on these types of questions. Now come in your question number 1. I am solving only one parts here, and rest of the things are in your assignment. Now come in your question number 1. This is 39, 52, 65, 78. These two words you have to tell. Look here, 39, 52. Just find out the difference between them. What is the difference? 52 minus 39 is 13. 65 minus 52 is 13. 78 minus 65 is 13. 91 minus 78, that means all are of 13. 13 only. That means we have to add 13 in previous number. If we are adding 13 in that number will come. Now come on your question number 2. 2, 4, 7, 11, 16 and 22. You have to tell that number. Just look here. What is the difference between them? 4 minus 2 is 2. 7 minus 4 is 3. 11 minus 7 is 4. 16 minus 11 is 5. 22 minus 16 is 6. That means what number will come in the next? 7. Because 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 will come. That means you have to add 7 in previous number. 22 plus 7 is 29. Now come on your question number 3rd. These they are saying 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. This is the sum of 10. And in this is the sum of 14. And in this is the sum of 18. And you have to tell the sum of these numbers. Simply 4 plus 5, 9. 9 plus 6, 15. 15 plus 7, 10, 22. Only these type you have to follow. And in this they are saying 5 5s are 25. 55 times are 275. One more 5 they are adding. And here also they are adding 7, 7. Again 5 add, that means triple times 7. Now again 1 time add, that means 4 times. This is again, that means 5 times. Only these you have to follow. And in this question they are saying you have to find out fifth number. This number they ask from you. Just look here. In this what you have to do? As like this is here. So many numbers you have, as like 9 is here. 9 multiply 2 plus 1. 9 2 is 18. 18 plus 1 is 19. 3 you have to tell. 3 into 2 plus 1. 3 2 is 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. That means the 3 is of 7. 9 is of 19. As like more number, as like 6 we have. 6 into 2 plus 1. 6 2 is 12. 12 plus 1 is 13. That means 6 and 13 will go. Now 8 is here. 8 into 2 plus 1. 8 2 is 16. 16 plus 1 is 17. 8 and 17 also here. Now what will left only?
Papa.
Now next number is 12. That means 12 into 2. 12 2's are 24. 24 plus 1 is 25. Like that only you have to solve. And in this what they are saying? First is 25, 21, 17, 13. What is the difference? 25 minus 21 is 4. 21 minus 17 is 4. 17 minus 13 is 4. That means this is the difference of 4. 13 minus 4 comes 9. Like that only. 29 minus 25 is 4. That means 17 minus 4 is 13. 21 minus 4 is 17. Like that only you have to solve all the sums. And what you have to do in chapter 13, these exercises, these sums you have to fill in your book. Thank you. Have